Hi guys, I want to show you Stem Manager. It's a script for Reaper that I wrote, and it makes exporting stems and any kind of submix that you might want a very quick and easy thing to do. Let's start off with a quick demo of what it does, and then we'll take a deeper dive, because this thing has quite a lot of features built into it. Alright, so we've got ourselves a mix here. We could just quickly add stems. Next, we need to define which tracks are part of those stems. And finally, we can render them. This is very basically what it does, but there's a lot more to uncover. Before we take a deep dive, let's talk about Reaper's current way of handling stem exports. In the render window, you can select selected tracks or selected tracks via master as your source. You then need to make a track selection. There are several things about that I find quite frustrating. First is that you'd need to either plan your stems really early on, or you need to make quite a few changes to your project. Now those changes usually involve some changes to signal flow. New folder tracks mean that audio will be passing through them, and it's more tracks to, well, keep track of. Now if you want, say, your backing vocals to be part of the backing vocals stem, but also part of the playback and backing vocals stem, and also part of an acapella stem, it could get quite tricky to get that right. Now, what if on top of that you'd want some of those stems to start off at a bar line, but others to start off right before the playback starts? That would be even more complicated to do. Now, if you want to repeat those settings on every mix you've got, that's a lot of steps to do each and every time, and it quickly amounts to hours of work. Alright, so let's see where Stem Manager can help you. First, whenever you're not sure what anything does, you can just hover over it and a small hint shows up down here. And if you want some more information, you can always open the help window. Alright, here's the main window. On the left, I've got my tracks, each with its own color. Folder tracks can be opened and closed by clicking that small arrow next to the track's name. And whenever tracks are hidden in the Reaper TCP, they're also hidden here. But I can always change that by going to Settings and checking Show Hidden Tracks. So the first thing I want to do is add stems. This can be done by clicking the big plus button here and giving the stem a name. Stems can be dragged to change their order. And I can click the context menu to rename, delete, and perform other actions with the stems. Now that I've got several stems, I want to start assigning tracks to them. So a stem is basically just some tracks soloed and maybe some other tracks muted. I can solo tracks by clicking an empty space here and dragging to add even more tracks. If I shift-click a track, I can set it to mute. If I alt or option-click a track, I can reset its state to, well, nothing. It's important to note that Reaper has two solo modes, solo in place and solo which ignores routing. The default solo mode can be defined in Reaper's preferences under Audio, Mute, and Solo, and Stem Manager will look at the setting and use that. If I want to use the other solo style, I can Command-click on a Mac or Control-click on Windows, and I'd get that, the one that I do not have selected in the preferences. And again, if you don't remember which key does what, you can always just hover over the rectangle, hold Alt or Option, Shift, Command, or Control, and you can see what each key does right down here. Now, let's say I have a solo or mute state defined in one of the tracks that are inside a folder track. When that folder track is closed or collapsed, I get this rectangle that reminds me that there's a track with a solo or mute state inside of it. If I open the folder track, there it is. By default, when I add a new stem, it takes whatever solo and mute states my project currently has and assigns them to the new stem. So if I have my vocals soloed and I add a stem, the stem is now going to have those tracks soloed in it. If I don't want that to happen, and I just want a new blank stem with no solo and mute states in it, I can Command-click on a Mac or Control-click on Windows, and I'll get a stem without any solo or mute states. I can also go to the Stem Context menu up here and select Get States from Tracks, and it will copy whatever solo and mute states there are in my project over to the stem. And I can go the other way too. If I click Set States on Tracks, I can have my stem reflected in the project's tracks. But if all I want to do is just listen to the stems, there's a better way of doing that. If I click that round button, I enter mirror mode. Immediately, the stem's solo and mute states get reflected in Reaper. And now, whenever I solo or mute a track in Stem Manager, it gets muted or soloed in my project. But also the other way around. So if I solo or mute a track in the project, it changes the stem accordingly. This allows me to hear my stems in real time. I can also keep my stem safe by Alt or Option clicking the round button. That way, no matter what I do in Reaper, it does not change my stem. Which one of these is the default behavior can be defined in the settings window under mirror mode. Either way, when I exit mirror mode, my solo and mute states return to whatever they were before I started listening to my stems. Okay, now that I have my stems and I've listened to them, I want to define how they'd be rendered. I can either render all my stems with the same settings or divide them into groups of stems, each with its own settings. I do that by hovering over the number under the stem name and clicking the up or down buttons to a different group. Now all the stems in group 1 will have the same settings, all the stems in group 2 will have the same settings, etc. To set those settings, let's head over to the settings window. Up here I've got global settings, we'll get to those in a minute, but down here, those are my render group settings. I can click the numbers to define which of the render groups I'm currently modifying, and I can give a description to each of my render groups. So, for my first render group, I'll call these stems. I can now select a render preset. Render presets can be created and modified in the Reaper render window. It's a relatively easy thing to do, and I left a link in the description to a video that shows how it can be done. The one thing to remember is that each stem is actually a master mix of a project, but that project happens to have tracks soloed and muted. So I'd want my render preset to either have master mix set as its source, or if you're using the region matrix, make sure to have master mix assigned to the regions you plan on using for the render. Now, since I selected a render preset that has selected regions defined as the render bounds, I can check the Select Regions checkbox to tell Stem Manager to select specific regions before rendering stems within that render group. To do that, I need to click that button, which opens up the Region and Marker Manager, where I can select whatever regions I want, and then head back to Stem Manager and click Capture Selected Regions. I can now see that two regions are indeed selected, and if I hover over the button, I can see the region's ID and name. It's important to note that if the region ID changes, that is, if you renumber the regions, you'd want to head back and reselect the regions for this to work properly. If I did not have Select Regions checked, Stem Manager will just leave whatever region selection I have at the time of rendering without changing it. Now let's say I use a render preset that has selected markers as its bound setting. I would take the exact same steps, only selecting markers this time instead of regions. If my render preset requires a time selection, I can make one using the same method. I'll just check Make Time Selection, then Make a Time Selection in Reaper. For this mix, I want my stems to start on a bar line, to make it easier to load them up in another project for live playback. So, let's make a time selection that starts off at the beginning of the project and goes all the way to its end. Click Capture Time Selection, and I can now confirm that the time selection I made is shown here. Now, whenever Stem Manager renders stems in this render group, it will first make that time selection. The next setting is Override File Name. Reaper will use whatever file name is defined in the render preset, but I can always change that if I want. I just need to check that box and enter a new name. I now have the ability to add the $stem wildcard, which will be replaced by the name of the stem when rendering. Notice that I can still use any other Reaper wildcards, such as BPM for example, which may be useful when exporting stems. My render preset renders everything to a renders subfolder inside my main project folder. I want my stems to be in a subfolder inside of that, so I can just check Save Stems in Subfolder, and let's put them under the stems subfolder. Render empty stems means that even if I don't have any solo and mute states defined, I still want to render this stem. Let's leave that unchecked for now and come back to this later. Now, let's say I don't want my stems to have any master processing. There's no setting that does exactly that, but what I can do is have Stem Manager run any Reaper action before rendering. So let's check pre-render actions and click the plus sign. Now let's find the Disable Master FX action from SWS and click Select. Of course, after rendering, I'd want those master effects to be re-enabled, so let's add that as a post-render action. Hit the plus button, select Enable Master Effects, and click Select. I can now close the Reaper action window. Before closing the settings window, let's take a look at the checklist, which helps us make sure everything is in order. If there's anything that I forgot, I will see it show up here. Right now, it looks like everything is fine, so I can close the settings window by hitting OK. I could just go ahead and render my stems now, but instead, let's add some submixes. Let's make a playback submix, what's called a TV mix, which is playback and backing vocals, an a cappella, and let's do a dry vocal with all the send effects muted. And while we're at it, let's add a new blank stem and call it mix. Now for the submixes, I want slightly different settings. So let's make all of these a part of render group number 2. And let's make the mix part of render group 3. Now let's go back to the settings window and define those. So let's call setting groups number 2 submixes and render group number 3 mix. And I'll choose the same render preset for both. But first of all, I want the time selection to start right where the mix starts and not on a bar line. I also don't need the BPM in the file name. And the folder should be submixes. And I actually want the master effects on the submixes, so I'm not going to add those actions in. Same pretty much goes for the mix, only that the mix will go in the main folder, and this time I do want to check render empty stems. Now, why is it here? Well, generally, if you have a stem that has no solo or mute states, you just get the entire mix, which is something you'd most probably never want to do, unless you're exporting a mix, which is what I'm doing here. So that's why Stem Manager will skip those empty stems, unless you explicitly tell it not to. Anyway, now I do want them rendered, so we'll just check that. Now let's take a look at the global settings. These are settings that are effective for all my stems. So first we have the render action. Stem Manager can either add tracks to the Reaper render queue. That is useful if we want to add lots of stems from different projects for rendering, let Reaper render all of them and return later. But the way Reaper does it is by reloading the entire project before rendering each stem. If I don't want that to happen, I can just have Stem Manager render the stems consecutively. To make sure that happens without any disruptions, I can check Always Overwrite, which will prevent Reaper from warning me that a file is going to be overwritten before rendering. I can then set a wait time between renders. Waiting between renders is important in two ways. First, for some reason, some plugins need to let things like reverb tails die down while Reaper is playing, or else they'll show up in the beginning of the next render. That's why Stem Manager will play at the end of the project when waiting for the next render, to let them die down while playing. The second reason is that this wait time between renders, that's your opportunity to cancel the whole render operation. Unlike rendering from the queue, here Reaper doesn't know that we are rendering a bunch of stems, so no cancel all is available. Instead, Stem Manager will allow you to cancel between renders while waiting for the reverb tails to die down. Anyway, I don't have any extra long reverbs, so I think that 5 seconds is a good amount of time for that. Other than that, we've covered all the rest of the settings. The last thing to note here is that all of these settings, both global and the render group settings, are saved with your Reaper project. You can make them the default settings for every project where you use Stem Manager by clicking Save as Default Settings. This will only affect new projects moving forward, so you don't need to worry about overriding anything you have going on in other projects. I'm going to go ahead and save these as my default settings. I can always go back to these defaults by clicking Load Default Settings. And if I want to reset my settings to a completely clean slate, I can Alt or Option click Load Default Settings, and they will be zeroed out to factory settings. Now let's go to the Create Actions window. Here I can add custom actions to Reaper's action window. These actions allow me to trigger behavior inside Stem Manager from everywhere within Reaper. So let's add toggling my drum stem to the Reaper action window by clicking Create. I now have a new custom action that I can assign a keyboard shortcut to, just like with any other action in Reaper. And I can use that action whether Stem Manager is open or not. The last thing I want to talk about before rendering is how Stem Manager saves its data. Everything is saved with the project, and the solo and mute states are saved with the tracks. This allows me to do several things. I've got a project template that I use for mixing. It already has stem definitions and track associations built into it, and every new project made from that template has all of those inside. If I duplicate a track, let's say the guitar bus, that new track remains a part of the guitar's playback and TV mix stems, just like the original. Now, if I create a track preset from this track, and I load it to a new project, you can see that Stem Manager knows that this track is assigned to these stems, so it already created them for me and assigned the track to them. And that's pretty much it. Back to the project, I can now click Render Immediately and go grab a cup of coffee. Thank you, and I hope you'll find Stem Manager as useful for you as it is for me.